Most of us have either received or heard of the phone scams that threaten to have people arrested if they don't shell out thousands of dollars. Well, tonight we hear from a young Concord woman who was conned and watched the moment the alleged mastermind was brought down by police.
A trusting 23-year-old who can't help but blame herself for being duped.
Fear, shame, regret. Anger, frustration.
But this is who police blame. Abdullah Khan, hauled out of his Parramatta apartment.
Are you behind this phone scam?
No.
How would you feel if you were tricked out of your hard-earned money?
I don't want to speak right now. I'm too stressed, please.
Stressed is an understatement to how the alleged victims felt. At least seven of them fleeced of $92,500 in 2 months.
This is a crime which sort of transcends the age barrier and flows across everyone in our society.
The con in Helen's case began with an automated call warning there was a warrant out for her arrest.
We've got someone using your tax file number to launder money and traffic drugs.
She says more calls and messages followed, including from the Burwood Police Station phone number. The hairstylist told to keep quiet and send her case officer almost $5,000 in Amazon gift cards.
I was, like, very suspicious the whole time, but also, like, the fear just kind of overtakes you and they're very, very manipulative. Every question you ask them, they have an answer for.
The following day, Helen was ordered to withdraw 10 grand and hand it to this man at her work in Barangaroo. The photo leading to the arrest of 19-year-old Ahmed Arshad, who is yet to face court.
Police search warrant! Please.
Yesterday, police moved on the accused mastermind.
Were you expecting the police at your door this morning?
Yeah.
You were?
Yeah.
Do you admit to any involvement in this phone scam?
No.
A magistrate told 20-year-old Khan has confessed, but claims he was forced into it by a syndicate in India.
Nine News has learned about another woman who lost more than $20,000 in life savings. The stress of it all triggered a panic attack and she ended up in hospital where the alleged scammers continued to call and harass her.
It's a pretty scummy thing to do. These people obviously barely intelligent, so it's, you know, a waste of talent that could be redirected to, you know, good things.
Tiffany Genders,